Hello, everyone. My name is Trisha. Tell me, do you believe in the paranormal? Personally, I don't really believe in it. But recently, terrible things began to happen in our house, and they happen every night. My brother is a skeptic. He never believed in ghosts or anything. But when he suddenly announced that he had something in his room that disturbs him at night, I became interested. And I decided to conduct my own investigation and check if this really was true. Everyone, including myself, were shocked. Trust me, I have a very ordinary family. We've never had things that would surprise any of us. We used to live in a small town in the same place where we were born for a while, and then my father was offered a job and we moved to a bigger city. We bought a house there. It was a two-story with a beautiful view of the park. My mom immediately fell in love with the area because it was quiet, calm, and at the same time, everything you need was within walking distance, including a park, a hospital, and shops. My brother and I used to sleep in the same bedroom, but in the new house, there was enough space to choose our own room, and this made us both very happy. We immediately ran up to the second floor and each chose their own bedroom. Parents had a bedroom on the first floor, so it means that the entire second floor belonged to only my brother and me. And it suited us. At first, as soon as we moved to a new place, I felt a bit uncomfortable because I was used to the old room, and the new environment was a little intimidating. Not that I was afraid of possible closet monsters, no, I just had to get used to it. The first 3 days, I did not sleep much. I even came to my brother's room a couple of times to calm down, but Jerry did not like it when I burst into his bedroom. He just advised me to go online less and watch less stupid stuff. That's all he said. He was a skeptic, as I said before, and besides, he was older than me and never worried about anything much. In the end, I got used to it and found a way out. I just put on music in my headphones and fell asleep. In the morning, I turned off the playlist and slept on. I loved it. That's how we lived in the new house for about a month. And then strange things began to happen and my brother was the first to notice them. I remember how we were sitting at dinner one day and Jerry suddenly said that he would sleep in the living room. Mom was surprised because you could never get my brother out of his bedroom. He said that the room was too cold for him and he wanted to watch the TV. He took his blankets and pillows and fell asleep in the living room. This continued the next day and then again and again. I knew Jerry too well, and then one day, when our parents went to bed early, I went down to him and asked what was going on. He was silent for a long time, did not want to speak, and then tried to lie to me that the room felt stuffy for him. And then I caught him. "You said you were cold," I said. He couldn't look at me. I realized that he was hiding something. I asked him to speak frankly. And then, taking a deep breath, he admitted that he could not sleep in his bedroom. This surprised him, and I wanted to know why. "There is something in there," he said. I did not understand right away. I began to laugh and joke. "Oh, your sock smells so bad that no living soul will come into your room. And if someone does, they will immediately suffocate." But my brother pulled me, and then his expression even scared me a little. He was serious. "I am not kidding right now, Trish. There's actually someone in there. I've noticed more than once," he muttered. And then goosebumps ran down my body. According to Jerry, it's not the first night that he hears weird footsteps while sleeping. First, he just felt a presence, heard light breathing. There is a huge tree outside his window in his bedroom, and at first he thought that it might just be a shadow of the tree and sounds of the wind, but the breathing and the steps cannot be confused with anything, especially since the window in the house do not let noise and wind through. Jerry tried not to think about it, but then one day he woke up from someone touching his feet, as if someone sat on the bed. Jerry got scared, he crawled under the covers and froze. His heart was pounding in his chest and he wanted to scream, but he was afraid. A moment later, the it disappeared. And when he stuck his head out and reached for the flashlight on the phone, there was no one else in the bedroom. He ran to my bedroom, but I slept soundly and he did not want to wake me up. Well, now his mind was occupied by this, and what he found on the internet added more to it. All sorts of scary stories were written by people, and he decided that he would just not tell anyone anything about this and just spend one night in the living room. But later, it turned out that this did not help him either, because even from there, he heard the door of his room open and close. For the first time ever, Jerry shared his fear with me, a fear that sent chills down my spine. He asked not to tell parents, and I promised to keep his secret. But I did not want to leave my brother like this either, so I immediately met up with my friend Scarlett. We became friends after I moved. She was a bit out of this world. She even believed in the existence of not only spirits, but even zombies. Well, if you did not pay attention to that, then she's a wonderful person, which is why we were good friends. Scarlett liked me for being friends with her. I shared my brother's story with her, and she immediately said that the ghost of the dead owners lived in her house. I made a surprised face, but she kept telling me that an old lady used to live in our house. Nobody liked her, and she felt the same about everyone else. The woman was angry and greedy, and then she died for some unknown reason. My friend is sure that her ghost is guarding the house, and for some reason she did not like my brother. Maybe because he lived in the room of her grandson, who was with her for some time, until her daughter-in-law took him away after divorcing the woman's son. Scarlett handed me amulets, dream catchers, and even gave me a candle to light in my brother's room at midnight. We performed all the rituals on time and even read some spells. Jerry looked funny saying incomprehensible poems, but I did not laugh so as not to upset him. So, a couple of weeks passed, during which Jerry spent nights in his bedroom full of hope that the old lady's spirits would disappear. But it did not disappear. Once, I even agreed to spend the night with him in order to understand what was really happening. But you know, I had a nice deep sleep. I did not wake up at all, and on the contrary, I slept even better than in my own bedroom. Jerry lay under covers like a child and did not breathe hearing the footsteps. And then he was always sleep deprived in the mornings. His condition began to scare me. He had lack of sleep, did not eat anything, and he always asked about Scarlett's advice. She even came to our house and cleaned his room with spells. But nothing helped. Then I decided to break my promise and tell my parents about everything. My mom and dad reacted skeptically, but when they heard everything, Dad suggested another way out. To install a camera and then watch whether there really was anyone. Jerry thought it was pointless because no ghost would be caught on camera, but I convinced him. That same night, Dad set up the camera and Jerry stayed alone in the room. He was tired of not sleeping for 2 weeks and he passed out almost immediately. I also did not hear or see anything. In the morning, we took out the camera and looked at the footage. At first, it was nothing abnormal, but then we noticed the door to Jerry's room open, and then my heart started pounding. A small shadow quietly entered, sat down on the bed. The room was dark and, oh no, oh God, we were still able to see the silhouette. "Trisha, are you pranking your brother?" my mom asked. I was the one in the footage. I went into his bedroom, sat on the bed, walked around, and then left. But I do not remember that. I began to make up excuses. My brother was angry, and only then Dad suddenly said that I was sleepwalking. Believe me, I couldn't do it. But it turns out that my grandpa was also a lunatic. Apparently, moving houses has such an effect on me. From that moment on, a therapist began to examine me to cure my sleepwalking, and my brother finally calmed down. My mom put a bed rag under my bed. When I got out of bed in my sleep, I would step on it and wake up. Now my brother is sleeping peacefully, and I'm being treated.